Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I wanted to show you guys how you can achieve these smoky eyes with just two eyeshadows. Yes, you heard me right. So if you want to know how I got this look, please keep watching. Hi guys, I've already applied the base, which is the foundation and concealer and powder. I have so many videos that can show you how you can achieve a flawless base. So let's just jump into the eye makeup. So to start off, I'm just gonna prime my eyelids with a concealer. You can use any concealer that you're comfortable with. So right now I'm using the Instant Age Rewind Concealer, just a little bit. So I'll just apply it onto my eyelids and I'll buff it out with a brush like this. This is like a dense, fluffy brush, eyeshadow brush. Now the reason why you prime your eyelids before you do any sort of eyeshadow is so that you can maximize pigmentation of the eyeshadow that you apply. I'm just gonna set the concealer with a powder. You can also set the concealer using a translucent setting powder. Now for this eyeshadow look, you need two brushes. One is a shader brush, which is flat and dense like this one, and the other is a fluffy blending brush like this. Now this is a dual-ended Anastasia Beverly Hills brush that I found in one of their palettes. Each of their palettes like these, they come with a brush like this. If you can't get that, I suggest you to just get any fluffy blending brush. You have like many that you can find on Amazon, like these. Just a regular fluffy brush. All these are just regular fluffy blending brushes, so you can get any of these. You can also get a shader brush like this. It's dense. It's used mainly for packing on pigment. So these brushes also you can find on Amazon. So for today, I'm going to be using this dual-ended brush, which has a flat shader side and the blending side. So I have my Jaclyn Hill palette right here. It has a wide variety of browns. You can pick any shade of brown that you find is more suitable to you. The brown that I picked was this reddish brown. You can pick out any shade of brown that you find complements you. For me personally, I find browns with red undertones to complement my skin really well. Onto the flat shader brush side, and I'm gonna start out with my under eye. So I'm just gonna pack it on to my under eye area. Once I'm done with that, I'll just gently pull it out with the same brush. And I'll also start to pack
it onto
the outer corners. Gently apply and blend all the way into the inner corner of your eye. You're packing and blending. So it's going to look really messy at first, but don't worry, we're going to blend it all out. So what I want you to do is, I want you to connect the lower part and the upper part into a nice little V. And when you barely have any product left on your brush, just gently pull it out. So what it does is, it will give you that nice little V in the outer corner. It's all about precision and pressure. Whenever you have to pull the eyeshadow out, make sure that you apply very little pressure. Repeat the process, but be very, very careful not to apply too much, because then it can get really messy really quick. You can also intensify the lower lash line a little bit more. And once you have barely any product left, just to pull it off. As you can see, the more I'm blending out this brown, the red undertones are starting to show. Now that we've roughly applied the eyeshadow onto the lower lash line and the upper lid, we can move on to blending it out. So for blending it out, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to use the fluffy end of the brush. I'm going to dip it into my compact powder. For today, I'm going to be using the Studio Fix powder by MAC in the shade NC44.5, which is a perfect match to my skin tone. So just pick out your compact which you use on the regular and you can use that. So this is the Studio Fix powder in the shade NC44.5. So I'm just going to pick it up on my fluffy blending brush. Tap off the excess. You need to make sure that you use a pigmented compact powder. The Studio Fix powder is like extremely pigmented. So I'm just gonna take it and I'm gonna gently start to blend out the edges. Now when you're blending out the edges, make sure that you don't apply too much pressure, because you don't want the eyeshadow to move around too much. So just apply enough pressure to get the eyeshadow to blend. You can go back into that brown eyeshadow and build up pigmentation. Now, if you see any fallout, you have to immediately kick it off. Don't let the fallout sit on your face for too long, because otherwise it can mess up your under eye. So just kick it off with a brush. So you can slowly see the eyeshadow blending and coming together. Just keep blending. You need to blend and build. Blend and build. We can move on to the shade for the lid space. So I'm going to pick out a really shimmery brown shade from the Jaclyn Hill palette, which is this one. This shade, it's called 24/7. It has like really pretty micro glitter in it, which is like so beautiful. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick it up on the same shader brush. You can also use your finger. Actually, if you use your finger, you can maximize on the pigmentation. But I find my long nails, it's very difficult to get precision. I'm just going to apply it with the flat shader brush onto the inner two-thirds of my eye. So I just want to blend out the under eye a little because it's looking a little too harsh for my liking. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go off camera, do the same thing that I did on this eye to the other eye, and I'll be right back. I just got done with the other eye. Now we can move on to completing the rest of our makeup. To finish off the eye makeup, I'm going to line my waterline with a black kajal. I'm using the Colossal Kajal by Maybelline. With a smoky eye, you don't want any white peeking through, which is why we are trying to darken the eyes as much as we can. So I'll just line the upper waterline and the lower waterline. Now let's curl our lashes, apply mascara, and I'm also going to apply falsies. I'm going to be using the Lash Paradise mascara by L'Oreal. Now, since I'm going to be applying falsies, I'm not going to apply too much of mascara. I'm just going to give my lashes a good base. You don't want your real lashes to stick through the false lashes. So you make sure that everything looks nice and dark. So for lashes, I'm going to be applying these accent lashes like in my last video. I just use the outer corners of any pair of lashes and apply it to the outer corner of my eye. So I'm just gonna apply a little bit of lash glue. You don't have to wear false lashes with this makeup look. You can totally rock this look with just mascara. But false lashes really do complete the look. So whenever you apply glue onto your false lashes, always make sure you add a little bit of extra glue on the outer corners because that's where the lash tends to lift. Just a little bit of extra glue for extra luck. So I'm just gonna place the lashes from above. Look down into the mirror. Secure the center of the lashes. Secure the outer corner. And then secure the inner corner. Once you're done placing the lashes, just pinch these false lashes with your natural lashes. So they look like a singular unit. You don't want your false lashes to just sit on top of your regular lashes. I'm just going to do my brows like how I did it in my last video, which is by using a mascara. That's complete. Let's finish off the face makeup. So I haven't applied blush, bronzer or highlighter yet. So let's move on to that. So for blush, I thought I'd pick out this neutral blush right here. It's from the Ultra Blush palette by Makeup Revolution. You can pick out any neutral blush. Usually whenever I do smoky eyes, I always make sure that my cheeks remain neutral. I don't want like too much of color going on. I want all the focus to be on the eyes. Always pull your blush back to your temples, so that it's really well blended out. So for bronzer, I'm going to be using MAC Studio Fix Powder in the shade NW45. So for highlighter, I'm going to be picking out this Golden Champagne highlighter from the Ultra Blush palette in Golden Sugar 2. This is also by Makeup Revolution. I've used it in my previous video. So it's this one. You can use any highlighter. I wanted to use a highlighter with golden undertones for this look. I'm just gonna set my face with a setting spray. This is by L'Oreal, it's their infallible setting spray. So now we can finish off the makeup with lipstick. I'm just gonna apply a nude lipstick. This is by Lakme. It's their 9-to-5 weightless matte mousse lip and cheek color. And it's in the shade Coffee Light. That's it, you guys. I hope this video helped you in learning how you can apply a smokey eye with just two eyeshadows. All you need is a little bit of practice. With practice, you can easily achieve this smokey eye. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video, because if you did, please give this a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Also, don't forget to click the bell notification button so that you get notifications whenever I upload a new video. So until I see you the next time, always remember, fair isn't the only lovely. Bye.